Welcome once again to Cooking in Finland. In this video, I finally returned to the requested multicolored pasta method. This is something you have to play around with to arrive at the product you want. I think the test one I made here had too much black in it and it was too big, so it came out looking more like an Italian Halloween dish. But the same exact method can be used with other colors, and if you use a finer setting and less black, you'll get something like this. Making the pasta itself is quite straightforward. You combine the ingredients in a food processor, whiz it up to get a dough, knead it a bit, and then wrap it in cling film in the refrigerator for at least a couple of hours, or just come back to it the next day. For the spinach concentrate in the green pasta, I used frozen spinach and a little dried basil. Add water, about half the weight of the spinach in water, and heat it gently to make sure you're not burning the spinach in any way. And although I used a regular stick blender on this, a Vitamix would produce a much more intense spinach flavor. The reason is that after you pass this through a sieve, most of the spinach gets left behind, but a Vitamix pulverizes it so fine that it becomes completely integrated. I already showed how to produce the butternut squash paste for the orange pasta, so I'm not going to repeat that here. When you've made your various colored pasta doughs, you roll it out into sheets using the machine as usual. Don't roll it super thin because it's going to get rolled more later. Keep it as sheets at this point. When you have your sheets rolled out, then cut it into strips as if you were making tagliatelle or spaghetti. When all of the cut strips of pasta have been laid out randomly, place another piece of parchment on top and use a rolling pin to smoosh the strips together. Now trim the pasta along with the paper so that it will fit through the pasta machine. Use a ruler and a sharp knife. The machine is then used to compress the strips of pasta dough into a single layer. This is the most challenging part of the recipe. You have to get it through the machine without it falling apart. For those of you who find it challenging to form ravioli the traditional way, there's a device you can buy that will make it quite easy to obtain uniform pieces that won't fall apart so easily when cooking them. You lay one sheet of the rolled out pasta on the frame, put in a teaspoon or so of the filling in each cup, brush it with a little water, and then lay another piece of the pasta over the top and use the rolling pin to seal the edges. As soon as these are made, you want to put them in simmering, not boiling water, for a couple of minutes to keep them from drying out. Then you drain them, put them into ice water to keep them from continuing to cook, take them out of the ice water, coat them with a little olive oil, and they're ready to be pan-fried for serving or boiled a little bit more as you prefer. I wouldn't put grated cheese over these because it'll conceal the work that went into them. The best approach is to put a sauce underneath them. As I said at the start of the video, if you choose lighter colors and cut the pasta thinner, you'll have a much better looking product in my opinion. It is more work that way, and I admit I was a bit lazy with this because I have a lot going on in my life right now, but it had been longer than usual in posting the video, so I went ahead and did this anyway. As always, my very sincere, heartfelt gratitude to my members, and I'm here for you if you have any questions any day, and I try to answer email within a couple of hours. Thank you.